Obesity. Obesity is the state in which there is an accumulation of excess body fat with an abnormal increase in body weight. Obesity is a complex multifactorial chronic disease developing from influence of social, behavioral, psychological, metabolic, and cellular factors. Overweight occurs if intake of calories is more than the expenditure of energy. Overweight and obesity are conditions where the body weight is greater than the mean standard weight for age and height of an individual. Body mass index is an estimate of body fat and health risk. Body mass index can be calculated by the formula BMI equal to weight in kg by height in meter square. Every 7 calories of excess consumption leads to 1 gram fat deposit and increase in body weight. Weight due to fat in adipose tissue exceeds more than 20% to 25% of body weight. An adult weighing 10% more than the standard weight is overweight and 20% more is considered as obese. Obesity is due to genetic factors, physical inactivity, especially eating habit, that is overeating, and endocrine factors. Obesity is a positive risk factor in development of hypertension, diabetes, gallbladder disease, coronary heart disease, and arthritis. Diet management is the most recommended preventive measure for obesity. High calorie food should be avoided. Avoid junk food. Low calorie, normal protein, vitamins and minerals. High fiber diet can prevent overweight. Calorie restriction for weight reduction is safe and most effective one. A low calorie diet accompanied by moderate exercise will be effective in causing weight loss. Meditation, yoga, running, walking and other physical activity can also reduce stress and overweight. Heart disease. Cardiovascular disease, CVD, is associated with disease of the heart and blood vessels. Coronary heart disease is the most common form and is caused by deposition of cholesterol in the blood vessel. It usually develops slowly over many years, beginning from childhood. They may form a fatty stick to a fibrous complicated plaque. It leads to the narrowing of blood vessels, leading atherosclerosis in the large and medium-sized arteries that supply the heart muscles with oxygen. It leads to sudden deficient blood supply to heart muscle and myocardial infarction, that is, death of the heart muscle tissue. High blood pressure and high blood cholesterol are the major causes and contributing factors for heart disease. If it is untreated, it may cause severe damage to brain and kidney. Sometimes it may lead to stroke. Causes of heart disease are heredity, diet rich in saturated fat and cholesterol, obesity, increasing age, cigarette smoking, emotional stress, sedentary lifestyle, excessive alcohol consumption, and physical inactivity. These are the major causes of heart disease. Symptoms of heart diseases are shortness of breath, headache, tiredness, dizziness, chest pain, swelling of leg, and gastrointestinal disturbance. Diet management for heart disease. Reduction in the intake of calories, low saturated fat, cholesterol rich food, low carbohydrate and common salt are some of the dietary modification. Diet rich in polyunsaturated fatty acid is essential. Increase in intake of fiber diet, fruits, vegetable, protein, vitamin are required. Regular exercise, walking and yoga are essential for body weight maintenance and preventive measure of heart diseases. Alcohol consumption and smoking, usage of drugs should be avoided to prevent heart diseases. Cancer causes about 4 million deaths annually throughout the world. In India, more than 1 million people suffer from cancer. It is derived from Latin word meaning crab. The study of cancer is called oncology. Cancer is an abnormal and uncontrolled division of cells that invade and destroy surrounding tissue, forming a tumor or neoplasm. It is a heterogeneous group of cells that do not respond to the normal cell division. The cancerous cell migrate to distant part of the body and affect new tissues. This process is called metastasis. The frequent sites of metastasis are lungs, bones, liver, skin, and brain. There are two types of cancers, carcinomas, sarcomas. Carcinomas found in skin, lung, stomach and brain. It arises from epithelial and glandular tissue. 85% of tumors are carcinomas. Sarcomas found in bones, cartilage, tendons and adipose tissue and muscles. It occurs in connective and muscular tissue. There are two types of tumors, non-malignant and malignant tumor. In non-malignant tumor, the cells do not spread to other parts of the body. But malignant tumors, the cell grow rapidly and damaging the surrounding normal tissue. Leukemia. It is blood cancer, most common type of cancer, which also affect the children below 15 years of age. Leukemia are characterized by an increase in the formation of white blood cells in the bone marrow and lymph nodes. Carcinogenic agents. Cancer-causing agents are called carcinogens. They are physical, chemical agents, ionizing radiation, and biological agents. Heavy smoking causes lung cancer, oral cancer, pharynx, and larynx. Excessive exposure to sunlight may cause skin cancer. Biological agents of cancer is virus. Cancer causing virus are called oncogenic virus. Radiation. Ionizing radiations like X-rays, gamma rays, radioactive substance, and non-ionizing radiations like UV rays cause DNA damage. It will lead to cause cancer. Cancer-causing chemical agents are nicotine, caffeine, products of combustion of coal and oil, pesticides, asbestos, nickel, certain dyes, and artificial sweeteners. Treatment of cancer. The treatment of cancer involves the method of surgery. Tumors are removed by surgery to prevent further spread of cancer cells. Chemotherapy. It involves administration of anti-cancerous drug which prevents cell division and are used to kill cancer cell. Radiation therapy. Tumor cells are irradiated by lethal doses of radiation while protecting the surrounding normal cells. Immunotherapy. Biological response modifiers like interferons are used to activate the immune system and help in destroying the tumors. Next, AIDS. Acquired immune deficiency syndrome. It is a severe viral disease and caused by human immunodeficiency virus, that is HIV. It is a condition in which immune system fail and suppress the body's disease fighting mechanism. They attack the lymphocytes and affected individual is prone to infectious disease. AIDS virus has been found in urine, tears, saliva, breast milk, and vaginal secretion. The virus is transmitted by an infected patient who comes in contact with blood of the healthy person. HIV is not transmitted by touching or any physical contact. It spread through contact of body fluids or blood. HIV is transmitted generally by sexual contact with infected person, use of contaminated needles or syringe, by transfusion of contaminated blood or blood products, from infected mother to her child through placenta. AIDS infected individual become immunodeficient. The person becomes more susceptible to viral, bacterial, protozoan and fungal infection, swelling of lymph nodes, damage to brain, loss of memory, lack of appetite, weight loss, fever, chronic diarrhea, cough, lethargy, pharyngitis, nausea and headache. The HIV presence can be confirmed by the Western blot analysis test or enzyme linked immunosorbent assay, abbreviated as ELISA. The treatment for HIV is antiretroviral drug and immunostimulative therapy. Both can prolong the life of the infected person. We can prevent the HIV virus by take following step. First, screening or testing of blood from blood banks for HIV before transfusion. Ensuring the use of disposable needles and syringe in hospitals and clinics. Advocating safe sex and advantages of using condoms. Creating awareness program among the people to know the consequences of HIV virus. People with HIV virus should not be isolated from the family and society. Children, in this lesson, we understand the types of abuse and how to protect ourselves from abuse and what are the ill effects of drug, tobacco and alcohol addiction. And what are the diseases and disorders associated with lifestyle modification? And we studied the cause, symptoms and treatment for obesity, heart disease, cancer and AIDS. In this lesson, you studied about prevention and control of these diseases and disorder. As a student, you have to aware of this concept about health and diseases, and you have to create awareness in the society about health and disease to lead healthy life.